Hello and happy Monday, everybody. It's Markus. Of course, I'm going to play another song for you this week. This one goes out to Marjorie. She's a kind, generous person, absolutely awesome, and one of the hardest working people I've ever met in my life. She's she runs the farm and the stall at one of the farmers markets here in London that I've played at for years. And she was one of the only reasons I made it through my first few years here. Being one of the great people, the market people have been fantastic. But yeah, this one, she asked me to do it for her one week. So I put it together, played it for her. Took me a little longer than it probably should have, but I did it. I haven't really played it much since, so I brought it back for this video, for this week. So Marjorie, this one's for you. I hope you enjoy it, and I hope the rest of you do too. This one's called When I'm 64 by the Beatles.
Sending me a valentine, birthday greetings, bottle of wine. If I've been out till quarter to three, would you lock the door? Ways to meet me, ways to feed me when I'm 64. You'll be indicate precisely what you mean to say. You're sincerely wasting away. Give me an answer, fill in the form. Mine forevermore. Ways to meet me, ways to feed me when I'm 64.
Hello everyone, welcome to episode 2 of Cooking with Markus. This week we're going to make a curried lentil and cauliflower soup. It's winter time, it's getting close to winter time, it's fall. We want to be cozy, we want to be warm, and we want to have some warm food. So that's what we're going to do this week. It's also a vegan recipe, and it's also gluten-free. So my friend Maria and anybody else out there who is vegan and gluten-free, or even just vegan, this is going to help. So let's get started. So first off, we need all of our ingredients. We got some garlic, lemon, carrots, potatoes, cauliflower, of course, and lentils here in a jar that I've got. Same with the curry powder that you can get from zero waste shops. You just take your jars or your containers and you fill them up and do that there. I got some coconut milk here, paprika, pepper, salt, and a little veggie stock cube. You can make your own veggie stock quite easily with real vegetables, and just do it on your own at home. But I'll do that with you another week. I don't have time to do it this week, so today we'll just be using the little veggie stock cube for that. And then, of course, we have some maple syrup, which is part of this recipe, which I've never used before in this, but it sounds like a fantastic idea. Okay, so before we even get started, we're going to take our half cup of lentils. In the recipe, it's actually green lentils that she's using. I have red lentils, so I'm going to use these, which will work just as fine. But beforehand, I'm going to pour the half cup into a bowl, and we're going to soak them for about 15 to 20 minutes.
So I've just rinsed off all my vegetables, the cauliflower, carrots, the potatoes. Make sure you do that. I won't show you though. And then I'm just putting the garlic into a jar here, and I'm just shaking it up to loosen off all of the outer parts. So then you pop them out. Luckily I have lots of jars lying around because I use them all for things. Okay, so that little trick with the garlic is pretty cool, popping it in there. I knew that from a long time ago, but I haven't used it in a while, and my friend Scott reminded me of that just the other week. So then what you want to do is you want to chop up, you're going to chop all the onions and all the garlic. It says four cloves, but the garlic that I'm using, the bulbs are quite massive, so I'm only going to use three, even though I love garlic. And usually the more garlic the better, but I think three will be enough. I'm just chopping my extra onions, and I'm going to chop my garlic. In the end, all of these veg and everything, the whole thing is going to be cooked and blended, so don't worry about chopping anything too fine. It doesn't matter too much. Onto our pot, we have the heat on medium to low. We're gonna put one tablespoon of oil in, which is what the recipe calls for, but I am putting whatever. So there's that. I'm using just regular rapeseed oil to add the onions and the garlic that we chopped up. And we're just gonna saute those for about 2 minutes until they look nice and soft. In the meantime, I'm going to chop my cauliflower, carrots, and potatoes and get them all ready. It says to use half of a large one cauliflower. I don't think this one's terribly large, so I'm probably going to use the whole thing. Up to you. I'm going to put the cauliflower, once it's all chopped, into a big bowl and just kind of get it out of the way. As you can see, they're not super small or anything, just enough so that they're going to cook down. Next, I got the carrots. I just chopped the ends off of them, and then I'm going to chop them into little chunks. This is a purple carrot. This is from the farmer's market, from Marjorie's stall, actually. And apparently my flatmate was just telling me that all carrots used to be purple, and for some reason now we have orange ones. But yeah, you just want to chop them up like that, throw them into the bowl with the cauliflower, and we're rocking along. Also, these carrots, some of you, the recipe calls for them to be peeled. Some people might like them peeled. I don't peel anything. I won't peel the potatoes either. And then once you got these, they go in the bowl. Next up, we're onto the potatoes. Potatoes, we're just gonna chop them in half, do a couple cuts, put these guys down like that. Again, it doesn't have to be anything fancy or amazing. We just want them chopped up, and we want them to be able to be cooked. Then we're gonna put the potatoes in our bowl as well. And now we'll take the sauteed onions and garlic, and we're going to transfer them into this larger pot, as I misjudged how large a pot I was going to need, which I should have known from before. But you will need a very large pot for this. So then I'm going to add all of this in with it, all of our veg, the cauliflower, the carrots, and the potatoes. I'm gonna add these two veggie stock cubes here. Usually the pack for the one says that one of them will do 450 milliliters, which is just over 2 cups. You want 4 cups of the broth, so I'm just going to put those in. I'm going to add some more water because I'm doing this tabletop. They have instructions on here for some kind of instant pot. I have no idea what that is. I just do everything on the stovetop, so I'll just add some more water to that, and that will spread those little guys out a little bit more. So I'm adding 5
maybe even 6 cups of water.
It says 1 tablespoon of curry powder, a little bit more than that, but basically that. It says a half teaspoon of paprika. I'm just going to add that much. Then we are back to our lentils. So we're going to take these and we're going to strain them. And they are ready to go.
And the lentils are going to go straight in.
And we're going to mix it all up. We're just partially covering this, and we're going to wait for 12 to 15 minutes, or until the veggies are tender and the lentils are cooked. So we'll check it in about 10 minutes and see where they're at.
Yeah, this is what you should have for now. But we're going to keep that lid on.
Okay, taking a second look here. Everything should probably be good now. Yeah, the carrots are good. Checking the potatoes, they're good. And the collies are good. We are good. So my blender that I have is not quite for, well, you can use it for soups, but it's, I think, more of a smoothie maker. So I'm gonna have to slowly do bits of it at a time, like this, and it's going to be a little bit slower than what it would be if I had the hand mixer, which it suggests, or a larger blender.
So I've got just the right amount in there now, and I'm going to use pulse to do it, and make sure we get a good consistency. So that first pot that I used is coming in real handy. I'm just putting the blended bits into this pot here.
Okay, so now we're going to add the coconut milk, the lemon juice, and salt, just to taste. Now the recipe here calls for a whole cup of coconut milk. I'm not a massive coconut fan, to be honest, so I'm cutting it down to a half, and I'm gonna see how that works. Next, I'm gonna squeeze the lemon in, so I just chop the lemon in half, just like that, and then I'm gonna use a fork here and just squeeze the lemon juice in. Okay, and then I'm gonna add the maple syrup. It says 2 tablespoons. I'm just gonna give it a little drizzle here. So this will probably be, that's probably about 2 tablespoons there. Okay, and with all of that, I will actually add a little bit of salt here as well. The recipe does say that you can cook it again, and basically just add the lemon and the salt and the maple syrup to taste, however you'd like it to be. So because I added so much liquid, I did add extra water. It is a bit waterier than usually when I make it. It's usually quite thick and chunky, but this is a really nice soup consistency. To half here, and I'm happy with the taste. And what I'm gonna do is here is just add a little touch of, this isn't vegan at all, this would just be for the vegetarians. I'm gonna add a bit of yogurt onto the top. So just a little drizzle here on top. You can make a little symbol or something if you want, something fancy with it for whoever you're going to be sharing it with. Make it look neat, make a piece of art. And then you can add pepper as well. And there we go. And that is the cauliflower and lentil soup, which is vegan, except for when I put the yogurt on top. That makes it only vegetarian. But hope you enjoy it. I hope this recipe helps you out. I'll put the actual recipe that I used in the description below. So do check that out while you're doing this. And I hope you enjoy it. And here we go. See you next time.
I wake up, it's early afternoon.